defense in the NFL takes on the best offense in the NFL in Week 14 as the Baltimore Ravens visit Arrowhead Stadium to battle the Kansas City Chiefs. This game has a great chance of setting up as one of those quintessential, sharp first public games. It also has to be a tough one for the oddsmakers to set, especially the total, which is at 53 points. The Chiefs are a 6.5-point favorite, but it was 7 or 7.5 earlier in the week, so we have seen some modest, sharp investment in Baltimore thus far. It certainly feels like Baltimore should be better than 7-5 straight up and 6-6 against the spread. Maybe going with Lamar Jackson earlier would have been the right call, as Baltimore is 3-0 straight up and 2-1 against the number with him behind center. Even with the best defense in the NFL from a yards per play standpoint, the under is only 7-5 for the Ravens, a reminder of how efficient the NFL market is on totals. The longer that Lamar Jackson is the starter for the Ravens, the more opportunities teams have to adjust. Jackson was not nearly as effective against the Falcons last week, as he only had 4.4 yards per carry and was only 12 of 21 passing for 125 yards. He did not throw an interception, but did fumble the ball 3 times and temporarily left the game to get a concussion test. Justin Tucker was very busy last week with 4 field goals in the victory. The Falcons also slowed down Gus Edwards, who had back-to-back 100-yard games. The Ravens offense may need to throw in some more wrinkles because there weren't many explosive plays last week, and Baltimore is still 26th in yards per play. Fortunately, the Ravens defense is stellar. Even though Baltimore has only forced 9 turnovers this season, the Ravens are top in the league in yards per play allowed and 3rd in third down defense. The Kansas City Chiefs may only be plus 20.2 yards per game this season, but that has been good enough to be 10-2 straight up and 8-3-1 against the spread through the first 12 games of the season. Every game matters from here on out if the Chiefs want home field advantage in the AFC playoffs. Kansas City is just 1-3-1 against the spread over the last 5 games, but 2 of those against the spread losses have been in games with a double-digit line. The Chiefs may not be as balanced going forward without Kareem Hunt, but Patrick Mahomes made it very clear that the team is just fine on his shoulders. In the first game without Hunt, Mahomes threw 4 touchdown passes with 0 interceptions, 0 sacks, and 52 rushing yards against the Raiders. He now has 41 touchdown passes against just 10 interceptions. We'll get to see how fast the Baltimore defense is, because chasing Travis Kelce and Tyreek Hill around the field is not easy. The Ravens did keep Antonio Brown in check earlier this year, but Hill's speed is a different kind of weapon. Kansas City averages 7 yards per play. Outscoring teams has been the best defense for the Chiefs. It seemed like maybe the defense was getting a little bit better, but allowing 897 yards and 57 first downs to the Rams and the Raiders over the last 2 weeks put a stop to that thought. If this total holds at 51.5 or higher, it will be the highest total ever for a Baltimore Ravens game. That speaks to just how potent and prolific this Kansas City offense is. The Ravens should be able to move the ball a little bit here. If they own the time of possession battle with Lamar Jackson's legs in the ground game, they will be able to keep this game close. This is also a big step up in class for the Baltimore defense, and other solid offenses have moved the ball well on Baltimore. The Ravens don't force a lot of turnovers, but have done a good job in limiting big plays. Nobody has limited Kansas City from the big play standpoint. The only way to stop the Chiefs seems to be to create turnovers, and the Ravens don't really do that. This is clearly the public's side to take, but Kansas City simply might have too much firepower for Baltimore. The Ravens' defense should slow down Kansas City to a degree, and the Chiefs have a good pass rush and pretty good play from the defensive ends. That should keep this game under the total of 53 points. We'll go with the Kansas City Chiefs to win this game both straight up and against the spread. Want some free money? Click over to BetDSI.com and get up to $500 free cash to move your bets along when you open an account today. Join all the action with a few fun and exciting wagers, because it's only a game until you bet it.